Ask Tom on Home Show.
Renee from Jackson, Mississippi has a question about an inspection failure.
Well, Tom, she just purchased a house with shiplap roofing that's splintering, and different sections seem to be black with soot, as you can see here. Renee writes that, I just found out there was a fire in 2004 and the inspector failed to disclose that detail, so I purchased the home. The inspector states the home is sound, but I'm concerned. An insulation contractor told me he can't do it because of the condition of the attic decking. He says he was a firefighter and said that the roof had had fire and smoke damage. The previous owner stated that he just had fixed a roof leak and that was really the whole show. So she wants to know, I've never purchased a home. I would never purchase a home if I knew it. What can I do?
I don't think you have a problem. It wasn't on the rebuild. They should have painted that decking. If the decking is solid and it's just smoke damage, you paint it with aluminum paint. That's common practice with all of fire restoration projects. I even have in my own house that I do this show right now. It was a burned down fire restoration project, and what was saved, we painted it all with aluminum paint. Now the aluminum paint doesn't keep it from rotting and it doesn't make it stronger. It just keeps the smoke smell from permeating into the house. Up in the attic, you don't have an issue. So if it's solid and your inspector said it's structurally sound, no insulator, I don't care if he was a firefighter, he can put them out, but he's not an engineer. He doesn't know about buildings. This is something that really bothers me, is when people go in and they claim because they did something. For instance, I have a friend that said, well, I know all about the construction business because when I was in college, I hung sheetrock for a month. It doesn't work that way, okay? He knows nothing about construction. All he knows is he didn't want to do it and he got out of it. So the fact of the matter is, I trust your inspector. I trust what was told you. And I think you're worrying for no reason. And for him not to take the job was not very bright. But you know what? Find somebody else to insulate it, because that's just wrong information. I can tell you that. And I mean that from the bottom of my engineering heart.
Now, even though she wasn't there clearly for the fire, Tom, should she now go up there and have that detail painted out up there just to seal that in? Or does it not matter because it's the attic?
If there's no smell, there's no issue. There's no reason to do it. It's not a big deal. If it's structurally sound and the inspector looked at it and found that it was just cosmetic, it's all it is cosmetic damage. The problem is if it's in a wall or something, or let's say you have a kitchen fire, which is real common, and the cabinets get all kind of smoked up, the whole kitchen's smoking up, your chicken's ruined, you finally get it put out. Everything is fine. It's just all black with soot and smoke, and you have to clean and repaint everything. You use an aluminum paint for a primer because you don't want to smell the smoke. So that just seals in all the smoke. They use also pigmented shellac too, but aluminum paint is usually what is used in fire restoration. It's just so the smell doesn't come out. Once that's done, then you repaint everything. You don't take the cabinets down because they had some black soot on there from the chicken that got, started on fire. So no, it's fine.
But in the attic, don't worry about it.
No, it's venting out. It's perfectly fine. What bothers me is this woman, right? Renee, I assume it's a woman. I could be wrong. It's a man. Whoever the homeowner is, they are being frightened now for no reason, and that bothers me. And the home inspector did his job, and some guy comes in and says, I was a fireman. I'm sure he's a very good fireman, but he can't tell me about house and engineering and structural integrity and things like that. It's not his job to do.
I think we're all clear where Tom stands on this one. You got a question. You want his clarity? Go click on Ask Tom. Then you can go on our website. We take videos, or you can send us a question in writing. Either way, we're happy to see what you got. Make sure you include a picture, because it helps us, like we helped Renee, understand what we're dealing with, and we can give you a more higher quality answer. And that's why we post these every day on our Facebook page, on the Home Show Radio YouTube channel, of course, at homeshowradio.com.